Good morning, my dear students. Always have a talent spirit and always have a good mind. My good name is Vanitha Mary. I am working as a science teacher in St. Antony's Government Aided High School. Before I take the class, I would like to tell about the future about the world. I would like to start the class with addressing and end with the conclusion, okay? Please listen. First one, addressing. Second one is about the future world. Third one is lesson content. Fourth one is home task. At last, conclusion. First addressing. Good morning to my dear students. Always have a talent spirit and always have a good mind. My good name is Vanitha Mary. I am working as a science teacher in St. Antony's Government Aided High School. Before I start the class, I would like to tell about the artificial telepathy, that is the mind reading. Okay, how to observe the picture nicely, okay. Without the five sense organs, one can express his mind to the others and that person can read the mind of this person. Okay, that is the artificial telepathy. Okay, next, thank you. Now we shall continue the lesson, that is the origin and evolution of life. We shall discuss about the lesson content. Origin and evolution of life. Now I would like to explain about principles of Darwinism. Principles of Darwinism. There are five kinds. First one is overproduction. Second one is struggle for existence. Struggle for existence. Third one is variation. Fourth one is natural selection. Natural selection. Fifth one is origin of species. Okay, first one is overproduction. Second one is struggle for existence. Third one is variation. Fourth one is natural selection. and fifth one is origin of species. Now I would like to explain about the overproductions. Living beings have the ability to reproduce more individuals and form their own progeny. It have the ability living being have the ability to form of their own progeny. Next, shall discuss about struggle for existence. Struggle for existence. Struggle for existence means it's nothing but there is a competition between the food and the space leading process. Okay, it's divided into two. Struggle for existence divided into three parts. Intraspecific struggle, interspecific struggle, and environmental struggle. Okay, intraspecific struggle. Interspecific struggle and environmental struggle. Okay, I will explain about this with the help of these three types. Intraspecific struggle means there is a competition between the same species. Interspecific struggle means competition between the different species. And environmental struggle means there is a natural conditions like flood, drought, heat and cold, etc. That is the struggle for the existence. Okay. Now we shall discuss about variation. That means characteristic features of all plants and animals. It deals with characteristic features of all plants and animals. Okay. Next, we shall discuss about natural selection. The process of selection of organisms with the favorable variation is called natural selection. That means, again, I shall tell the process of selection of organisms with the favorable variation is called natural selection. Okay. The process of selection of organisms with a favorable variation is called natural selection. Next one, at last, origin of species. Fifth one, origin of species. According to Darwin, new species originate by the gradual accumulation of favorable variations for a number of generations. According to Darwin, new species originated by the gradual accumulation of favorable variations. Okay. According to Darwin, new species originated gradual accumulation of favorable variation. These are the five kinds. Again, I will recall the title only. First one, overproduction. Second one, struggle for existence. Third one, variation. Fourth one, natural selection. Fifth one, origin of species. Okay. Now we shall discuss about briefly about the variation. That means it is the raw material which plays an important role in evolution. Evolution would not be possible without variation. Okay. It is the raw material it plays an important role in the evolution. Important role in the evolution. Third one, evolution would not be without variation. Evolution would not be without variation. Okay. Now we shall discuss about types of variation. It's divided into two. Somatic cells and germ cells. That is the somatic variation and germinal variation. Somatic variation produce body cells. Next, it produce germ cells. Okay. Now we shall discuss about germinal variation and the types. Germinal variations. It's divided into two. Continuous variation and discontinuous variations. Continuous variation and discontinuous variations. Okay. Continuous variation means it's a small variation. It's called fluctuating variations and also occur by gradual accumulation in the population. Example, height and weight and also different kinds of eyes, different color of eyes and different color of skin. Okay. That is the small variation. Small variation and also it is called a fluctuating variations. Fluctuating variations that is occurred by the gradual accumulation of the population. Example, the color of skin, the color of skin, weight and height, different colors of eye. Colors of eyes, etc. Next, discontinuous variation. Sudden changes occur due to mutation. Okay, that is the short-legged unconscious sheep, and also six or more digits in human. A discontinuous variation means is occurred due to mutation. Mutation. Example, short leg and corn for sheep. Short leg, legged and corn sheep. Six or more digits for humans. Okay. Now we shall discuss about paleobotany. In Greek, paleo means old, botany means study of plants. Okay. In Greek, paleo means old, and botany means study of plants. Study of plants. Okay. Next, we shall discuss about the importance of fossils. importance of fossils. It deals phylogeny and evolution of plants. It gives a historical approach to the plant kingdom. It is very useful for the classification of plants, and also it is used in the field of descriptive and comparative anatomy. Okay, I shall write the keyword only. Okay, first one, it deals with the phylogeny. It deals with the phylogeny and the evolution of plants. Phylogeny and the evolution of plants. Next, it gives the historical approach to the plant kingdom. Historical approach. Historical approach. Historical approach to the plant kingdom. It is very useful for the classification of plants. Classification of plants. It is very useful in the field of descriptive and comparative anatomy. It is used in the field of descriptive and comparative anatomy. Now we have to know the founder of paleobotany, Gaspar Maria von Sternberg is the father of paleobotany. Next one, Birbal Sahani is the father of Indian paleobotany. Birbal Sahani. Sahani. Is the father of Indian paleobotany. Okay. In between, I would like to explain about the, there is a recall about the flowchart. Flowchart showing the postulates of Darwinism. First one, overproduction. It explains about the struggle for existence. It explains about the variation. The variation divided into two types. Organisms eliminated from the environment and natural selection. The natural selection explains about the survival of the fittest. That will explain about the inheritance of acquired characters. This will explain about gradual accumulation of favorable characters. At last, origin of new species. Okay, that is very important question. You have to by heart it. Okay, thank you. Next, we shall discuss about the fossilization. Now we shall discuss about the fossilization. It is the process of formation of fossils in the rocks is called fossilization. It is the process of formation of fossils in the rocks is called fossilization. Okay. It includes terrifications, molds and cast, preservation, compression, carbonization and filtration, etc. Okay. Now we shall discuss about determination of age of fossils. Radioactive carbon C14 dating method. It is discovered by W.F. Libby. Okay. The death of plants and animals can be calculated by measuring the rate of carbon-14 present in their body. Okay. Now we shall discuss about ethnobotany. Ethnobotany. Now we shall discuss about ethnobotany. It is the study of regions, plant and practical use and the traditional knowledge of people. Traditional knowledge of people. Okay. Now the importance of ethnobotany. It provides the traditional use and also give importance about the known and unknown plants, and also it will serve useful information for chemists, pharmacologist and a practitioner of herbal medicines. I would like to explain about the importance of ethnobotany. It provides traditional use. It gives information about known and unknown plants. It will serve useful information in the field of chemists, pharmacologists and practitioners of herbal medicine. The parts of the plants are used for the diseases like diarrhea, headache, fever, jaundice, leprosy and also snake bites. Okay. So we already finished the portion of this lesson. Now I would like to discuss with the home task. Okay. Home task. Home talks. Write the flow chart. Write the flow chart showing the postulates of Darwinism. Second one, write the importance of fossils. write the importance of fossils. Third one, write the importance of ethnobotany. Write the importance of ethnobotany. Okay. So, addressing is finished. About the future world is finished. Lesson content, home task, and we shall discuss for the conclusion. Okay. It is time to end of this session. I would like to tell something for you. Give more importance for the studies. You must know the value of life. Respect to all. Be happy always. Take care of your health. Thank you.